And when you go on a low carbohydrate diet, what we see is the big risk factors for cardiovascular disease go away. So having type 2 diabetes is probably the biggest risk factor for heart disease out there. I remember being told at university that a person with type 2 diabetes has the same risk as someone who's had a heart attack of having a heart attack. So having type 2 diabetes is an incredible risk factor for having cardiovascular disease. And we see on a low carb diet, type 2 diabetes, often people achieve remission. We also see blood pressure improve. And we see these funny lipids, which a lot of people don't know to look at, which is their triglycerides and the HDL cholesterol, they get better. So we see it. They suddenly improve on your
blood. Yep, so make sure you look
at them. They're a real marker. They're saying you're metabolically unwell and this is a risk factor for heart disease. Gosh, you've gone low carb. They're better now. That shows me you're at lower risk. As well as that, inflammation. Heart disease is an inflammatory condition, and we see on low carb that people's inflammatory marker, their CRP, that goes down. So inflammation goes, people lose weight, diabetes goes away, heart disease goes away, these lipids improve. So your risk for heart disease reduces. But then we've got left that one little guy, that LDL cholesterol that terrifies everybody. And what you probably don't realize it's a lot more complicated than LDL cholesterol. This bad cholesterol comes in 7 different sizes.
Certainly does.
And those people with diabetes have got the nasty ones, which are called small dense particles. So if you eat a high carbohydrate diet, you will increase the number of your LDL particles that are nasty, that are small and dense, more likely to cause heart disease. But you go on a high-fat diet, you'll see that cholesterol become a large, fluffy particle, which is less likely to cause heart disease. So looking at LDL cholesterol alone is not a good marker. And that's why doctors are moving to measuring something called ApoB, which is more accurate for particle number and not so much particle size. But anyway, that's boring. But what I want to say to you is eat fat, enjoy it, eat the cheese, don't eat the biscuit. And the problem with saturated fat is two. Number one, saturated fat in your liver, okay? So that's the fat you need to worry about. Not the fat in your meat, but the fat you make in your liver is saturated fat. So that comes from sugars and starches. So your body makes saturated fat in your liver. You get fatty liver disease. That saturated fat, and that's the guy you don't want, not the one that you're eating. And so overwhelmingly, I think your risk of heart disease will reduce dramatically by cutting out the sugars and starches and eating those fats that come with cheese, full fat dairy, with meat and a bit of dark chocolate after dinner. So that's my rant.